Kia ora. I'm Sean Ashley, and welcome to the Viewmasters of the Universe. Now, what we're going to be talking about today is the talking Viewmaster. Now, you might notice it's basically a Model G, a strap to a speaker with a record player attached to the back. These are the instruction stickers here, and if you've never used one before and you have one and you don't have the instruction stickers and you can't figure out how it works, pause it right now so you can have a read of the instructions, because it's really important. Now, we're going to talk about all of that stuff in a second. Let me tell you about the history of this Viewmaster. In 1969, this technology was patented by Gaff. It was probably the first iteration that they tinkered around with since acquiring Viewmaster from Sawyer's in 1966. Now, there's a lot going on in this Viewmaster, and there's a lot of information floating around out there about the cons of this Viewmaster. Now, this is a shout out to the collectors. If you're into a Viewmaster for the novelty of the Viewmaster, and obviously you're getting them for the viewer part, but you want to thinking about one of these because it talks, you're getting it for the novelty, not because of the quality of the sound. If you want the quality sound, you need to stay in 2018. There's a lot of information floating around out there about how poor the sound quality is, and basically the concept of this particular design was way ahead of its time. They didn't really have the technology that made this product very viable. That being said, if you're a kid in the 70s and you had this, you were legit. This was considered basically the Rolls Royce of Viewmasters for the time. Now, basically what happens is, inside that slot, it's a larger slot than usual, and you can see like a slightly longer slot, that's for your reel, and then the big deep slot, or the wide slot, is for your sound disc. Now, each reel comes with its own sound disc. I don't know if you can actually see it in there, I don't think so. You can kind of see it there. See, you can see the number there. So the sound disc and the reel ever become separated, they are numbered so you can put them back together. I wouldn't separate them if I was you though. Now, what happens is you insert it just like any other normal Viewmaster reel into your Viewmaster, give it a click with the advanced lever, and then push through a spring release, and that's going to synchronize the sound with the reel. Because as you advance the lever, with every advance, it plays its next sound on the reel, which on the sound disc, I should say, which is actually really, really cool. Now, the thing that lets us down is obviously the sound quality. Now, most of the sound is coming up there, but you've also got like a hole or a cavity here for people sitting around you to still be able to hear the sound as well. But most of it comes out from the front portion of the Viewmaster. So, this is one of the better reels that I have, the better sound disc I have, actually. And the sound quality varies from disc to disc, and probably from Viewmaster to Viewmaster when you think about it, because of the record playing mechanism on the inside. And how it works is really simply, the reels go in here, and when you push the sound bar, the whole record player mechanism on a spring moves toward the sound disc. And there's a hole about here, and a prong comes out, and a needle comes out, and the prong starts rotating the sound disc, and obviously the needle makes contact with the sound disc and plays the little mini record. There are a couple of cool videos out there on YouTube, and I'll see if I can put the link to them, where people actually, of older version discs from the 80s, whereas these ones are from the 70s, they put those discs on record players, and you're able to hear the actual record playing on a record player. Now, my personal opinion, having heard those and heard these, they work a little bit better on a record player because it's a record player, and this is a very poor man's version of a record player built into a child's toy. And that's what I say, like, if you're a collector and you want it for the novelty value, I would get one, because I love it. I think it's cool. And even though the sound isn't that great, I still love it. It's like hearing my childhood. If you're someone that's buying one a Viewmaster for the family and you saw this and thought, "Wow, that's cool. The kids will love it." Probably not. The kids, your children are a product of the thousands, and they have an MP3 player, and you're probably watching me on YouTube. They don't want this. My son prefers Model H, which is the lighted Viewmaster, to this one. He says he likes it, but he likes Model H better. He's just trying to not hurt my feelings. Now, the cool thing is that when we look at it at a face value, that's basically the standard model G viewer there. But they did release a version that was probably the predecessor and their experimentation into creating Model H. And it's this blue one here because the color scheme is the same. And we're going to look at Model H in another episode because we haven't done so already. But there you've got the one that I've got there, and this is the talking electronic lighted viewer. Now, they did release a like the technology evolved through time, and they had what's called the electronic talking 3D Viewmaster. It's a really, really long name. It's like they just tacked on a few more like verbs and adjectives and whatnot to make it sound cooler. But basically, as the technology improved, the sound quality improved, and it probably with this the GAF series of Viewmasters got to its highest point in about the 80s, 1984, I believe. Because they were able to sign Michael Jackson to an exclusive deal where they would make reels with him and sound reels from his popular music videos of the time, and they put those into the Viewmaster. The most famous probably being Thriller, which is around that time. And I think it worked well for both parties because they'd kind of perfected the technology at that point, and Michael was getting into like the whole cinematic thing, especially with Thriller. So it was a good medium to release it on. That being said, when GAF sold their properties on to other people, the Talking Viewmaster carried on in various formats. And one of the more well-known ones is probably the Tyco Viewmaster, and I'll try and put a picture of it in here. Which met with a lot of controversy because it probably wasn't as good as they were probably hoping it to be. Like, Tyco is probably famous for its research and development, and they might have bitten off more they could chew with more than what they could chew with that one. So, what are my personal feelings on this Viewmaster? I love it. I think it's great. And that's a genuine I love it. I think it's great. Not a sarcastic I love it, I think it's great. Because of the way that they package the reels, and you get them in these special boxes with a deep disc plate to protect the sound disc and the booklet. Generally, what I've found is that they're in really, really mint condition, and the pictures are fantastic. Normally, the gaff reels of this era have gone magenta, and I don't know if these predate Kodachrome, like. These are Kodachrome still before they switched to different film, but the ones that I was able to get are fantastic. There's no bubbling, no none of them are magenta. There's a little bit of wear and tear where they've been, fed into the thing, but other than that, they're in super, super good condition. And I partly put that down to the packaging, that it's so sturdy and safe. I think for me, this is an investment. But like I say, if you're someone that's going to buy one straight off the street and you're looking for a cool Viewmaster and you saw one on eBay, I would go for something probably like a Model E or a Model G first before you get this one. And then once you get hooked, then get this one. Or even better, get the lighted one. The lighted one would be fantastic. Hopefully that was informative for people. For now, I'm going to say ka kite. Please make sure that you share this with people that are interested in Viewmaster or people that are speculating about whether they should get their first Viewmaster, because hopefully this will help out a few people. Put your questions in the comments line below, because I love to answer people's questions and I'm generally pretty quick on my responses. But for now, ka kite. I'll see you next time. I'm Sean Ashley, and thank you for joining me on the Viewmasters of the Universe.